stand for the anthems, the Star Spangled Banner, and the tikvah, which will be led by Cantor Richard Starshevsky.
About an hour before graduation, I was using a dictionary, and on the page that I was at, I saw the word okay. I assumed that it was a word that was a legitimate English word derived from, I don't know, Latin or Old English or French, and I noticed that, in fact, it was derived from two initial words, zero, period, and K, period. Started to be used in the English language about 1840. Where it came about, you want to look it up in the dictionary. You're leaving, Hillel. I'd like you to remember only two letters, much like OK. And that is alphabet. You say to me, but I learned that in pre-nursery school. What's the big deal? And wasn't that a gimel, dalet, hey, vav, zayin, chet are not important? But alef bet means something. I'll give you an ancient meaning, and I want to give you a meaning that I just learned about yesterday. Aleph-Bet, the Aleph is the first letter of the Aseret HaDibrot of Anochi Hashem Elokecha. In the Aseret HaDibrot you have all Tayyat Mitzvot. You've reached a great milestone, but let me tell you something, you've got a long way to go. So you start again in ninth grade with the Aleph, the Anochi, the Mitzvah. And I got news for you, by 12th grade, you'll look back and realize that in ninth grade you really didn't know anything. The Bet is Bereshit Bara Elokim, and that's where the Torah begins. That's where it started. Bara Elokim et Hashamayim et Haaretz. And that's why you're here, because it was God who created this world. That's the ancient interpretation. And Jews forever knew, especially on Shavuos, the Aleph of Anochi and the Aseret HaDibrot, and that was the core of the Torah as we do it today, and Bet is the underpinning, the philosophical underpinning that this world was created by a God. Yesterday I learned that Aleph Bet may stand for something else, and that is Ein Breira. I met a woman in the Senate office in Washington of Senator Phil Graham of Texas. He wants to be President of the United States in 1996. Her name is Mary Elizabeth Kedley from Roanoke, Virginia. She was there together with another woman asking the Senator to do something on behalf of B'nai Yisrael and Eretz Yisrael, because there's a dangerous situation coming up in the Senate. And I said to Mary Elizabeth, what brought you on board? And she said to me, Ein Breira. I have no choice. I said, what do you mean you have no choice? Ein Breira. I have no choice but to fight to make certain that Israel and its people are secure. Well, some of you come to Yom Israel the Shabbos, I'll tell you more about her. But let me tell you one thing. As you leave Hillel Academy, can you please remember Aleph Bet Ein Breira? 9 out of 10 kids never had a Hillel Academy education who are Jewish. They don't have any choices. They don't know what it means either to be or not to be. They just don't care anymore. You have to carry the burden for 90% of the kids who will grow to be Jewish. They are not yet aware of what you are aware. Ein Breira. You're going to have to carry a burden 9 times as difficult. You are going to be faced with immense choices. A Nintendo you may grow out of, so you're going to go on to bigger things. But if you have a choice between knowing that there is something specifically Jewish that you can do, and something so typically American, something that gives time meaning when you do it, as opposed to killing time, please remember, Aleph Bet, Ein Breira. Don't take the choice that's easy. Take the choice that's difficult. Because the harder you lift weights, and the heavier they are, the stronger you become. I need for you to flex your muscles as you get out of here. And from 5 pounds to 10 pounds, and from 10 pounds to 20 pounds, obviously I'm not talking about physical. If you want to lift weights, go right ahead. I'm talking about responsibilities in Torah. And that is my message and my hope. You have got to do it in a way that is Ein Breira. You have no other choice. Because this is the way you started out in kindergarten learning Aleph Bet, with one or two exceptions over here. In case you learned Aleph Bet a little later on, now get going. Ein Breira. Mazel tov to you all.
Unanimous choices of our faculty committee on honors and awards. Both students will now address you, delivering speeches which they compose. to deliver the 1995 Hillel valedictory address and to receive the accompanying Robert Freeburg Memorial Award. It is my honor to call on Chana Amalek, who will speak in Ivrit and intertwine it with a synopsis in English. Chana.
Thank you.
graduation.
Present Ilana Stelma, the salutatorian of the class of 1995 and the recipient of the Fannie Finkel Memorial Award. Ilana.
Tonight to Josh Dora.
present the Herb and Jackie Klein Award for Community Service, I'm very pleased to call on the donors of the award, Mrs. Jackie Klein. Change roles from receivers to givers. present the class gift to the school, I am pleased to ask Elior Shiloh to come forward.
Good evening. On behalf of the class of 1995, it is my honor to present this check to the school. While we would have wished to purchase a new Arnold Kodesh, we are designating this gift to refurbish the present Arnold Kodesh. It is but a small token of our appreciation for all that the school has done for us, and special hakarat hatov for our teachers and rabbeim for all they have given to us. I would like to give special gratitude and thanks to two very special people who have influenced my life and increased my knowledge of Yahadut, my Torah knowledge, and my ma'asim tovim, good deeds. I would like to thank our Rebbe, Rabbi Cohen, who influenced me greatly. You have only been my rabbi for 2 years, but what I have learned from you will help me in many years to come. You have inspired me in your divrei Torah, and most of all, you have inspired me to learn Gemara. You have taught me the ways of the Gemara and many ways in which it can be enjoyed. We have learned many interesting and important subjects, which I am sure will assist my decisions in the future. You are not only a rabbi to me, but you are a friend whom I can talk to and even tell jokes to. The knowledge that you have taught me will remain in my head, and the care you give to the class will stay in my heart. I only hope I'll meet inspiring teachers like you in the future. We wish you good luck as a rabbi in Connecticut, and you will truly be an asset in the congregation there. I would like to thank my principal, Rabbi Feinstein, who is a very special and important rabbi to me. I have had the honor of being your student and friend for 3 years. During these years, I have learned a lot from you. You have raised my self-esteem many times and helped me in complicated situations. Your doors were always open to me and other students. You have directed us in the right path of life, and we are very grateful. Thank you.
Special presentations that are not listed in your program. Karen Malaki has been asked to make these presentations. Karen, please come forward. Program over to the graduates, they will carry the program forward. So I will use this time of recognition for Mrs. Parkhoff and Mrs. Jacobson to make several additional acknowledgments about the presentation. We would like to thank the following for their assistance in the presentation and with this evening's graduation. First of all, the two young men who have and will be assisting behind the stage, to Eli Gurak and to Michael Schaffer, to Mr. Schember, who will be running the slide projector in a little while, for obtaining the slides and showing the slides, to Mrs. Gore and Mrs. Monty for all their work in the office on behalf of tonight's program, and finally, we thank the staff of the Y for their cooperation in making all the arrangements for tonight. Finally, there are two other acknowledgments which are not included in the program. We are here to honor the graduates, but their honor is also the honor of two groups of individuals who have made total commitments to those graduates. First and foremost, those whose life is dedicated totally to the welfare of these young people, who rejoice in their joys, agonize over their struggles, suffer every pain and disappointment, and tonight merit the nachas of their achievements. Graduates, I ask you to lead us in the applause as I ask all the parents and the grandparents of the graduates to stand and receive our salute. I ask all members of the Hillel faculty who are present to please stand and accept the Hakarat HaTov, the gratitude of all of us for your efforts on behalf of our students. Faculty members, will you please rise? Points. One, to deliver the Dvar Torah at the beginning, and later on to introduce the slideshow. I had the notes for one in one pocket, the notes for the other in the other pocket. When the time came to be called up for the slideshow, I somehow went looking in the wrong pocket and I started to pull out the Dvar Torah. And I said to the person who was standing next to me, I wonder what would happen if I started the Dvar Torah over, how many people would even realize that I was saying the same thing. Two years ago at the dinner, I'm letting you know ahead of time, I told a story about the Bonaventure Rov. But I want to retell the story. First of all, the graduates, I don't think were there. But even if they were, it's a story that bears constant repeating. It's a story that's told, that was told by the former Rav of Yerushalayim, Rav Bezalel Sholti Zatzal, who told how in 1940, on Yud Gimel Tammuz, Rav Sholti met the Bonaventure Rav in Yerushalayim. At that time, the situation in Eretz Yisrael was very serious. The Germans were on the Egyptian border, ready to conquer Egypt. And everybody knew that the next stop and really the goal of their thrust was to head to Eretz Yisrael. The Yishuv was certainly gripped in a state of fear and trepidation. The Bonaventure Rav met Rav Sholti on the street, and he said to me, you know what I did today? I purchased land in Bnei Brak to rebuild the Bonaventure Yeshiva. And I borrowed 500 English pounds to do it. You'll ask, how could I do such a thing under the circumstances, and why would I do such a thing? He said to Rav Sholti, I'll tell you why. We're taught in Yirmiyahu, Perek Lamed, that the Navi was told to purchase a field from Chanapel. In the same incident, Yirmiyahu, while being told to purchase the field, is also told that they would fall into the hands of the Kasdim, the Babylonians. But at the same time, he was told, Od yiknu batim v'sadot u'chramim v'aretz hazot. Yirmiyahu asks, if we're going to fall into the hands of the Babylonians, so why are you asking me to buy this field? To which Hashem replies, Ani Hashem Elokei kol basar, hamimeni palei kol davar. I'm the God of all creatures. Is there anything beyond my capability? And then he continues to promise kibbutz galuyot, the ingathering of the exiles, Shivat Zion, the return to Eretz Israel, and the rebuilding of the land. So the Panamitra Rav said to Rav Shalti, that's why precisely now was the time when I had to go and purchase land to rebuild the Panamitra Yeshiva in Eretz Israel. Two things are stressed in this incident. One is the obvious faith in the face of obstacles, which certainly is not just not logical, but it's against logic. It defies logic. But that defiance of the logic of history is one of the central elements that's behind the fact that we, the Jewish people, are still here today. The second foundation was that he went to found the yeshiva, the place of Torah. You are graduating in a historic year for our yeshiva, celebrating 50 years. At this past year's dinner of the Yeshiva Gadol of Passaic, at which I was a guest, Rosh Yeshiva Rav Meir Stern happened to share a thought which I found worthy not only of remembering but of repeating. I know that you remember the parsha from Parshat Mishpatim about the Eved Ivri, how the Eved Ivri was a servant for 6 years, was supposed to go free in the seventh year. But we're taught that if he refuses to go free in the seventh year, after having his ear pierced, he remains an Eved. And the Pasuk says, Ba'avado la'olam, which translated means he will serve him forever, for eternity. And yet we know that in fact the Eved only served until the Oved, until the 50th year. So the question is, how come it says Ba'avado la'olam? And Rav Stern brought a most beautiful and meaningful answer. He said that in the Torah, 50 years is la'olam. Why? Because within 50 years, it is possible for a person to fulfill every one of the 613 mitzvot. Life is meant to be measured not by a quantity of measurement, but by the quality of a person's life. And therefore, 50 years can be an eternity. You all have abilities. You all have wonderful personal attributes. But what you will achieve in your life depends on the degree to which you believe in yourselves, and secondly, on the degree to which you choose to act to realize that wonderful potential which you have. We know that you can do it, we are confident that you will, and we wish you great success in the future. Now, the moment for which you've been waiting for a long time, the presentation of your diploma. Chana Buria Amalek. Ezra Michael Greenfeld. Joshua Dov Gura. Karen Khanna Malaki. Alex S. Rafal. Elior Daniel Shiloh. Moshe Israel Starashevsky. And Ivana Tanya Stelhar. Now I will ask all the graduates to please stand as we salute. Thank you.
cheer. I was one of them, the children of Teresa, one who saw everything, the barbed wire fence, the rats, the lice, one who knew hunger, dirt, and smells, one who heard trains arrive and leave, screaming sirens and the tread of heavy feet in the dark. I sat in Irina Sinkova's classroom to write and paint the story of those days. I never saw another butterfly. The last, the very last. So richly, brightly, dazzling yellow. Perhaps if the sun's tears sing against a white stone, such a yellow is carried lightly way up high. It went away, I'm sure, because it wished to kiss the world goodbye. For 7 weeks I've lived in here, hands up inside this ghetto. But I have found my people here. The dandelions called to me and the white chestnut candles in the court. Only I never saw another butterfly. That butterfly was the last one. Butterflies don't live here inside the ghetto. My name is Raya. I am a Jew. I survived Syrian, not alone and not afraid.
Jewish line is finally ours. damn swastikas on their way.
Pavel Chavez!
Eric Chavez and Nash about to join us.
Pavel, if you're not careful, resign.
Be careful. We must all be careful. Tonight the plane, tomorrow the tanks.
Tomorrow? Joseph, what do you mean?
Today, I lost my job.
Joseph, it can't be true.
We all know it had to come.
But you were promised.
Promises? What do they mean? I must report to work at Leader Mercy. They are building a station.
But Papa, you're not a carpenter. You're a teacher.
Hush, Raya. Let your father play.
Today, they came to the school. We were given 1 hour to clear away books, papers, everything. 1 hour after all those years.
And what about the school? Anna, wait. There's still more.
Mama, it may be that. They'll have to move again. The landlord is German, and we are Jews.
Pavel, try to have patience.
We are Jews. They're relocating the boundaries 12 blocks on either side. And we must all of us move into the area of the old ghetto.
So, once again. But Papa, they promised.
How soon?
Tomorrow.
By sundown. Motei Shabbat, Anna.
They give us the shops to get ready. It seems to work again. What'd you tell him, Father?
What should I say? Some say it's the last order.
Someone always says it's the last order. But every day, the ghetto grows smaller.
What should I have told him? What does a Jew tell his German landlord?
They can't expect us to.
And Vera?
The women, too. They're released to work in the streets.
All married women must report to work in the streets. With the men.
Erica?
Erica too. Mama, it may be that they'll have to give up teaching. She's no longer allowed to teach.
Erica, where is she?
She was turned out in the streets with the rest.
But we thought the council was gonna appeal. Why do they sit waiting while the whole National Party walks in?
There have been meetings.
Talk!
Their considerations! So you'll attack, shout slogans, you and your friends, be brave.
Better than Heim Heim prayer, Shaw.
Kyle, you go too far.
At least shouting lets the National Door alive.
You go too far, too far! You think I don't know your joke at the regional theater?
The regional theater? What are you talking about? Pavel, you know Jews aren't allowed to.
A little joke on the guards. What do you know? So we stomped the lights in ambush near the theater arcade. They never knew what happened to them.
A joke? Not so amusing. This morning, Hannes was speaking. His number called before the rest.
Why Hannes?
Joseph, you are not telling us all.
A guard knows one on the council. He said he recognized his son among the pranksters.
But Hannes wasn't there. He didn't even know about it.
Pavel, it might have been you and Papa.
The guard said he recognized it. There's no quarreling with the Nazi guard.
And the rest of the council? They didn't intervene? No protested?
Hannes is on the train now.
That word, a coward.
Pavel!
We won to the star shop.
You go too far, too far.
Sorry, Father.
But you cannot understand.
I understand. I have this to remind me.
What is this talk? The star cannot destroy us, but I'll tell you what can.
Adam, what does nobody say?
I will tell you what can destroy us. To starve. No white bread, no meat, fish, fruit, poultry, jam.
Anna, please.
None of it for a Jew. To be denied the necessities of life, this will destroy us.
I know that, Mom.
And for your father, no tobacco, no cigars, cigarettes, no beer. All the little pleasures in life taken away.
I know that too, Mom.
And the big ones too. The schools, the synagogues, all taken away. This will destroy us.
Mom, for God's sake.
No, I'm not yet finished being a Jew. It means for all of us separation and the fear of separation. Planes today, tanks tomorrow, and always the guards, the Nazis. You and your foolish bravado, we may all be lost. All lost.
I know that, Mom, but to just endure, it seems so.
Weak? To you, it's weak. But think, the Nazis want us to work. If we must work, we will eat. There's that chance for life.
I don't close living.
But while we live, we stay together, perhaps later.
Yes, if they bid us work, then we will eat. This war cannot last much longer.
Yes, Mom.
Alright? Alright. So no more shouting and no more jokes on Nazi guards. In a few months, we'll be back in our flats. Huber has promised to keep the furniture for us. He does not wish us harm. He'll be back when we return.
Yes, Mom.
And you and Erica will be married as we planned. I promise.
Promises. Like you said. What do they mean?
Mama.
Tanks, the guards, they're in the street.
Asher Kedishanu b'mitzvoso b'tzibano.
Start the cordon off the street.
You'll be here soon.
The Hadlik Ner Shel Shabbat.
Thank you. To all commanders of the Passions, we are going up to the old city. We are going up to the Temple Mount, to the Western Wall. The Jewish nation is waiting for our victory. Israel is waiting for this historic hour. Go up. Succeed.
June 7, 1967. The soldiers of Sahar will defend the army of Israel press on. Through Asian winding streets, up and on, fighting, falling, seeing friends go down before enemy fire, taking shrapnel wounds, pressing on, and then a cry went up.
The wall! The wall! Hundreds of voices from hundreds of throats.
The wall!
And officers and unit commanders.
Uniforms, battlefields, faces caked with dirt and blood. Eyes that never wept the blush of death or suffered mortal wounds. Now streaming with tears as wild as they cried, "The wall! The wall!" They crowded through the narrow alley. They rushed at the wall, the Western Wall, embraced in ancient stone.
And the blue and white flag fluttered up above the ancient Kotel HaMaravi, the Western Wall. And a song rang out, Yerushalayim Shel Zahav.
Rabbi Gord, the chief rabbi of the Israeli Defense Forces, with a scroll of the Torah in one hand, with a shofar in the other, brought the shofar to his lips and blew a loud blast. Tekiah. Shvar. Terah. And 100 lips cried out, and the soldiers of Israel, for a brief space of time, rested their weapons and paused to pray for the newly won temple wall, the Western Wall.
That's the way it was, nations of the earth. That's how the children of Israel came back to Jewish land, to the Western Wall. Judaism's holiest shrine. You dare say it's big? You dare suggest that Israel abandoned Jewish land now? Why, Jewish land is the heart of the Jewish people. Can a man live without his heart? Come with me, you bark of the future of Jewish land. Come and learn the meaning of Jewish land. To the Jews of Israel, to the Jews of Jewish land,
let us return to 1948.
Mama.
What is it, Raya?
I'm thirsty.
Go to sleep, Raya.
But I'm thirsty, Mama. My throat hurts so.
Go to sleep.
I can't.
Try.
I'm trying. Honestly, I am.
In the morning, they'll bring water.
You said the same thing last night. You said that Pa would come and bring bread and water and meat.
Hush, Raya. Now you promised not to cry. Your father, a Holocaust survivor, is fighting so that you can live in freedom. He is willing to risk his life so that you and all other Jewish children can live in a free Jewish Jerusalem. Remember that. Remember that and be proud and never cry.
Where was the world then? They decided to internationalize Yerushalayim. What did they do in April and May and June of 1948 to protect the Jews against Arab invaders?
For several months, the world looked on while hundreds of men, women, and children died defending Yerushalayim against invaders. The men and women risked their lives to bring food and water to the city. The defenders alone saved the city from destruction. Now Yerushalayim, all of it, the old city avenue is Israel's. Jewish prayers, tears, and hopes for generations, Jewish blood poured out of its defense, have united Yerushalayim and Israel. No power on earth can tear them apart.
Why didn't he bring water? Why didn't he come back?
He couldn't.
He promised.
Can't you be quiet?
Mama.
I'm sorry, Raya. I didn't mean to. Listen to me, Raya.
Yes, Mama?
You must listen to me, and you mustn't cry. Do you hear?
I won't cry.
You must be a brave girl. You must be brave. Just as your father was.
Was?
Yes, Raya. Papa is not coming back.
Not ever?
You know what has been happening?
Yes.
Do you know that the Arab armies are all around us in the old city?
Yes.
Well, last night, some of our fighters tried to break through the Arab lines. Papa was one of them.
Now Papa will never come back.
Where shall we go next? Shall we go back in time 2,500 years? Shall we stand, silent witnesses in Yerushalayim, put to the torch by the Torah's
We're back.
Jerusalem, the Holy, is ours again.
The Western Wall is ours again.
After 1900 years.
We've taken it back.
With our blood.
We've taken it back.
With our lives.
We've taken it back.
Mincha.
Rabbi Gurren sang out. Mincha, the afternoon service, in the midst of battle, while enemy fire rained death upon them, where the temple of Shlomo, destroyed by fire, crashes to the ground, where only the western wall still stands, a remnant, towering above the ruins. Shall we listen to the weeping, the lamentations of the prophet Yirmiyahu, bewailing the destruction of Jerusalem?
Echa yashavata ha'irati ha'avai sakavala.
Let's go. you, O Lord, shall rule, you alone, over all your works of Mount the dwelling place of your glory. And in Jerusalem, your holy city, turn the pages, you who want to decide the fate of the holy city, turn to the holiday prayers. Lead us, rejoicing, to Zion, your city, and to Jerusalem, the place of your sanctuary, with everlasting joy.
Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 1995.